Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. The linear correlation coefficient R is a number that measures how well the graph of paired data fit a straight line pattern. Its value shows the strength and direction of the linear association between the two quantitative variables. Correlation coefficients close to negative 1 or positive 1 indicate a strong correlation, and values close to 0 indicate a weak correlation, with 0 indicating no correlation at all. So here's a picture I got from maths.nayland.school.nz. And you can see over here where R equals negative 1, the points fall exactly on a straight line, but it's negative correlation, meaning when one thing is small, the other value is high. When that same value gets larger, the other value gets smaller, so negatively correlated. And then here we see negative 0.7. You can see that there's a downward trend. It kind of looks linear, but the dots are definitely not falling completely on the line. And we see less correlation until we get to 0, where we really can say there's no linear relationship whatsoever. And then we can start to see it form to the right as positive, more positive, and finally R equals 1, the points fall exactly on a straight line. So if you're evaluating whether there's a correlation or not between two things, you look at how close they are to 1 or negative 1 to decide if there's a strong correlation or not. A correlation between two variables exists when one of the values of one variable are somehow associated with the values of the other variable. When that relationship makes a line, then we have a linear correlation. So things can be correlated in a way that's not linear, but we're just looking at linear relationships. Linear coefficients have no units. They fall between the value of negative 1 and 1. Linear relationship, the R coefficient is only designed to measure linear relationships, not for any curved relationship models. Whether the scaling of the data does not affect R, and the order of the data does not affect R, and the order of the variables has no effect on R. Both variables must be quantitative, and it's not resistant to outliers. And when we say it's not resistant, we mean it's sensitive to outliers. So a few outliers in your data set could cause you to lose that linear relationship. There is a formula to find R, and here it is, but we're going to use technology because we don't want to spend time doing that. But if you are asked to use the formula, there's a lot of summations in here. That symbol, that capital sigma, should not be intimidating. It just means to add them up. So when we see the summation of x, y, that means multiply the x value with the corresponding y value, and then add them up after you've done that for each one. Remember, when we're talking about correlation, there is an x that matches up to a corresponding y. So they would say and multiply those two together and multiply and then add those all up. The n in front means you're going to multiply that times the number of paired data that you have. This is just add up all the x's, add up all the y's. I want to just state right here, this one on the bottom says take x value, square it, and then add all those squared x values up. But this over here says add up all the x values, and once you've added them all up, then square that value. So that means two different things the way that x second power is. So just be careful of that. And as you look at that and think about all the work it would take to do that, then think about all of us who had to take statistics before we had technology to do that work for us, and be glad you're taking statistics in the 21st century. Okay, we'll have some examples coming up. Have a fantastic day.